Croaker Spot with my man Ralph. You are the general manager, correct?
That's correct.
Okay, so I just wanted to ask you about Croaker Spot. So when you come to Richmond, the first thing people tell you is go to Croaker Spot, right? So I want to know, how does that make you feel? How did you guys get it that way? How did you build that reputation?
Reputation starts from the very beginning and from that home. As a name, he had a vision on how food should be, how hospitality should be, and how the decor should be. So you put those three things together. That's great taste of food, and you know, great decor, and great service. And then you have a great product.
Absolutely.
And it comes right into people wanting to come and wanting to be around. The story, the way it is,
okay.
Mr. Croaker was actually one of those guys that in style for the times, and he frequented nice places.
Right.
I guess you have the old-fashioned after-hour club, or the juke joints. You know, when the party died down, everyone wanted to go to this other place and hear the music. I always envisioned the man with the big bass sitting in the background playing smoke-filled rum, but everything nice and cordial on a higher level. So Mr. Croaker traveled up and down the East Coast. He settled in Harlem. That was one of the places that, you know, he figured the restaurants there. Well, when his time had come, he came on back to settle when he started in Richmond. Just in talking, the owner happened upon him one day. They were sitting down having a conversation. He was telling him about the importance of the restaurant and the big three things that really make it great. That's great ambiance, great product, and great service. So with that in mind, the owner, when he endeavored to start his first restaurant, decided, why don't we call it Croaker Spot? And I've been thinking some terms of a fish, which is a croaker, spot, which is a fish also.
Yeah.
But Mr. Croaker, so he was thinking in terms of, if Mr. Croaker were here, would this be a place that he would put in his list of things to do with places to go?
Okay.
So Croaker's Spot.
One thing I have noticed about your food is the portions. The portions are so large. You know, you go a lot of places, you might get a steak that's big, costs $50, and a little celery leaf or something like that. So one thing I have noticed, guys, that huge portions. Why is that?
Well, when you eat, some of the greatest deals in the world, in this country, were closed over nice, delicious food. To its entirety, you want to be full to the capacity. You want to feel good about yourself, and you don't want to have something that tastes good, but when it really starts to melt and get in your mouth and going down, it's all gone.
Yeah.
So we purposely make the sizes large so that you have enough for today